Watch and we'll show you how to manage your AT&T Collaborate Enhanced Mobile Service. We'll show you how to customize settings for your users and your site. To learn how to manage voicemail settings, watch Choose a User's Voicemail Type. First, let's review some common user management tasks. From your desktop, log into Business Center and access Collaborate. On the Company Information page, under Users, click Manage Users. Find the user that you want to manage, and then click the user's last name. On the Users page, click the tabs to see more detailed information. For example, click Apps to see the apps assigned to this user. To change the user's settings, click the icons near the bottom of the page. Let's say that you want to change the user's dial restrictions. Dial restrictions are important because they determine which calls a user can place and receive. First, click Manage Settings. Then, on the Manage Settings page, click Manage Dial Restrictions. Next to Standard Dial Restrictions, click the Edit or Pencil icon. You can block domestic, international, or directory assistance calls for this user. Just slide the switch to the right to turn a restriction on, and to the left to turn it off. Make sure to save any changes. You can also assign custom dial restrictions to the user. Custom dial restrictions are ones that you've created. To create custom dial restrictions, from the menu on the left, click Administration, and then click Company Settings. For now, let's go back to the Users page and see how to change an extension. One reason you might change a user's extension is to make it correspond to your extension plan. For example, you might want all field text to have extensions in the same range, 1001, 1002, 1003, and so on. To change a user's extension, click User Information and enter the new extension. You can also change the user's time zone. The time zone is important because it affects how schedules are implemented. Remember to save your changes. Users are automatically assigned the most commonly used features. To change a user's features, click Manage Settings. On the Manage Settings page, click Features. You'll see a list of features available for the user. You can assign and unassign features, or you can manage a feature's options. We've looked at how to manage users. Now we'll look at some common site management tasks. We'll start on the Site Information page. If you want to manage the auto attendant or hunt groups for the site, select the option under Call Handling. Now, click Edit Site Information. Here, you can change the site's name or its time zone. The site's time zone is used as the default time zone whenever you add a new user. And as always, remember to save any changes. By default, the caller ID shown during a call is the user's phone number, but you can have the site's phone number shown instead. First, check that this is the correct caller ID for the site. Then, at the left, under Administration, click Features. On the Site Feature Settings page, under Caller ID, click Edit. Next, select Use Site Settings. When the page expands, select Show the site's caller ID information to the call recipient. If you want to show the user's extension for calls placed within your company, you can adjust those settings here. Again, remember to save your changes. When you're done customizing the settings for your users and the site, it's time for your users to complete their setup. Remind them to look for a text with a download link for the application. Want to learn more? Check the Business Center Help menu for Collaborate enhanced mobile videos and step-by-step help.